In this episode, we'll visit the Stuxnes of Lofoten, Skarksanden Beach. Skarksanden Beach is famous for the fact that it's a sandy beach in Norway. From a photographic point of view, the sand is interesting as you can find rich textures when the white and black sand mixes. The most iconic part of the beach is the iconic mountain across the water, which works as a fantastic focal point. The mountain reminds me a lot of Stuxnes, also known as Vesterhorn in Iceland. Located next to Flagstad and the main road through Lofoten, Skarksanden Beach is super easy to find. There's a parking lot next to the beach which includes toilets. We visited this beach several times with different goals in mind. One time during sunset, which delivered no colors at all but a great moody scene. The long beach makes it easy to catch some reflection photos of the mountains when the water recedes. So right now I am trying to catch the reflection of this mountain here, and I'm doing so with the tripod low into the water. I have a fairly closed aperture of 13, which forces me to have a shutter speed which is fairly long, but it's okay because it smooths out the water. Right now it has started raining, so it's not so optimal, but it's okay because I've already got some which are fairly good. But right now the tide is coming in, so it is a bit risky staying here, and it seems like we are getting a shower too. We've got showers all day, but it's okay. It's what's expected from Lofoten. I also tried out some long exposures of the receding water, making some beautiful streets leading the eye into the scene and the mountain. I really ended up liking these very simple and minimalistic long exposures. They have this cold Nordic desaturated tone to them. Along the beach there are plenty of possibilities for interesting foregrounds. The sand, the water and the rocks are all elements which you can use to your advantage. If you don't like the beach and want another foreground, you can use the rocks along the parking lot instead. Skarksanden is also a great place to photograph the northern lights. However, if you have just a few clouds, especially low hanging, the light from the town Vareid, which is located next to the mountain, will probably obscure your view. The northern lights were active the first night I had in Lofoten, which was also the first time I visited this location. It's less than optimal to go to a new location when it's night and all dark, and we did have the clouds lit by the nearby town, so the aurora photos didn't turn out too good at Skarksanden. We decided to go to another location not too far away at a road leading towards some mountains. Because it was night, I didn't get to film here, so that location will have to wait for when I return to Lofoten. From the end of May to the middle of July, you will have the midnight sun lighting up the location, giving you only a narrow window around midnight for photographing the golden hour. I'll recommend to not hit that period for photography if you only want to go during the summer half of the year. Going during May and between the middle of July and middle of August will give you more time to photograph, and you will also have time to change location while the sun is below the horizon. In that case, you will photograph through the late and early hours and sleep during the day. Close to Skarksanden, you will find Flagstad Church, which is also worth checking out for photography. Especially during winter, the red church will make for a great subject in the snow. At this location, everything between 16 and 50 millimeters comes in very handy. Thank you so much for watching. I know this episode has been fairly short, but I simply don't have more to show and I don't want to waste your time. As always, I'd highly appreciate a like and a comment. In the next episode, which will be the last from Lofoten for now, we'll go to another beach called Utterclev. And I promise we will end with a bang.